St. Louis, Missouri, instantly recognizable for its massive gateway arch by the vast expanse of the Mississippi River. It's also home to 57-year-old Tony Perkins, who teaches at Roosevelt High School.
My work with school children means the world to me. I absolutely love what I do.
Tony is facing an overwhelming battle against a painful and disfiguring disease. Tony suffers from keloids, a rare skin condition which erupts after he receives a graze or a cut on his face, neck, or body. Instead of creating scar tissue, large, unsightly lumps of collagen form, and they begin growing outwards. These lumps are called keloids.
I have about 7 keloids on my body. The biggest one, other than the ones on my face, would be right here in the middle of my chest.
As well as on his face and neck, Tony also has keloids on his stomach and arms.
The keloid is a scar that the scar tissue doesn't know when to stop growing outside of the surface of the scar.
The keloids around Tony's neck are so chronic he is barely able to function, which over the years has caused great distress for both him and his family.
I never knew, but I could hear him sometimes in his room, not really just crying, but moaning. And I was in my room, tears coming out, crying for him and praying for him. But when people don't understand, they are so cruel. They'll look at him, they'll point, they'll sniggle. It's not funny.
They laugh, they stare, I've been followed around the grocery store. I was treated different in the job interview.
But just as Tony reached his lowest ebb, help arrived from an unexpected source after his niece sent his pictures to a well-known plastic surgeon.
It must have been so overwhelming that they were like, no, we need to see you in our office. When can you come? You know, I'm really getting pumped up, you know, and really feeling confident to see him.
Today, Tony is in New York City to visit Dr. Michael Jones, a world-renowned specialist who has developed a method of preventing keloids returning.
So this upper part is completely attached to this back part of the ear. You're gonna have a little bit of a raw surface. Now, what I'm gonna try to do is try to take as much as we possibly can so that we're only really left with this strip here and then this part here.
Okay.
The treatment is the first to combine surgery with radiotherapy to kill the cells forming the collagen, which prevents keloids returning.
Now, how many surgeries are we talking about? At a minimum, you're gonna probably need 3. Possible that you might need 4 cleaned up here. Okay, we'll make it happen.
Tony is ready for the most important operation of his life, which could mark the start of his fight back against his keloids. The team anesthetize the patient. He will be unconscious throughout. Dr. Jones has opted to start the operation with the keloid over Tony's left ear. Each keloid is a hard and rubbery fibrous lump made up of collagen.
So this in and of itself is going to make a difference. We're actually going to weigh these.
As the keloid over Tony's ear comes off, Dr. Jones makes a startling discovery.
That whole piece was covering his ear, and it's actually warped his native anatomy. I wasn't expecting that at all. I think we're gonna try to do the other side. Okay, here it comes. That's it. I'm gonna say 2 pounds.
The largest keloids are removed one by one to be replaced in turn by the healthy skin stretched across the wounds. The operation has gone a lot further than expected, with the keloids on both sides of Tony's neck removed. Back in St. Louis, Tony is delighted with the result.
He was only supposed to do the left side of my face. I had one right here that covered my ear. He was only supposed to do that, but he ended up doing both sides of my face.
I just want to thank Dr. Jones because Dr. Jones is like the best to me. He is like Superman, Batman, all the superheroes rolled up into one.
One year later, Tony is recovering back in St. Louis. Dr. Jones has removed the keloid on Tony's chin and is using regular radiotherapy to keep the keloids in check.
The radiation kills the keloid cells that are deep down within the skin. It is a synthetic radiation, so it doesn't cause any harm.
Today, Tony is finally getting his life back.
Now he's back to sharp dressing again and everything, and he loves the kids. The kids love him. He's back to teaching and everything.
Now with the radiotherapy apparently working, Tony is hopeful that he can stay keloid-free for as long as possible.
I have a life that I have to live. I have so many people in my corner that I really realize now that are in my corner. So if they do return, I'm just hoping that it won't be as bad as it was, and you know, I can just continue to do what I'm doing.